The initiative is part of strategies to better position the island as a competitive yachting destination. Six incentives form part of the initiative. They include an increase in the length of stay for visiting yachts, 100% waiver on import duty and consumption tax on yachts, equipment and imported material, and boat safety and water sports activity equipment.
We're hoping that Saint Lucians will take advantage of this and by extension establish charter companies which our yachting product needs to become and remain competitive. Also included in the concession is the extension of stay from 6 weeks to 6 months for visiting yachts persons, which we know will have a greater impact on the economic activity on the island. We're also hoping that established ports like Rodney Bay Marina and Marigot Bay and even Soufre through the SMMA can take advantage of the incentives for the improvement of infrastructure.
The director of Yachting says it's important that the environment be created for Saint Lucians to invest more in the yachting sector.
We're hoping that key pieces of legislation are passed very soon to allow the registration of yachts in Saint Lucia. We are at a time now where there are a lot of other destinations that are beginning to put things in place, primarily Antigua, which will become very competitive for us for going after that business. So I'm hoping that the powers that be, running parallel to this cabinet conclusion, really move quickly to ensure that the necessary legislation is in place.
Mr. Didier says with the new cabinet conclusion and a viable yachting registry if approved, he's confident that the yachting industry will experience growth by 15% in the next 2 years. For the DBS News World, Jason Holland Seed reporting.